Dysarthria is a motor speech disorder in which the muscles that produce speech are damaged, paralyzed, or weakened. Motor speech disorders like dysarthria are due to the nervous system damage. Many neuromuscular conditions can result in dysarthria. Hi, my name is Govika. I am lecturer in Vinayaka Mission Research Foundation, Puducherry, in the Department of Audiology and Speech Language Pathology. I am presenter of my co-author, Mr. Rakesh Sivi, and I will be presenting on topic dysarthria with oropharyngeal dysphagia secondary to ganglion-capsular intraparenchymal hemorrhage EKS report. Clinical study focusing on a 52-year-old male came to the Department of Speech and Language Diagnostics with the complaint of slurring of speech and associated swallowing difficulties since 4 months post-hemorrhage. CT revealed that IPH in the right capsuloganglionic region and chronic lacunar infarct in both the capsuloganglionic region. So in clinical examination, we have done perceptual, acoustic and physiological observation for speech components. First is respiratory component. In respiratory component, a reduced vital capacity, reduced IOPP, reduced syllables per breath group and reduced maximum vowel duration. And same, they have shown increased initiated irregular breathing pattern and increased paradoxical ribcage abdominal movement and difficulty altering automatic pattern for speech is also observed. And second, moving to the articulatory component, emphasize consonants, short rushes of speech, variable rate, repeated phonemes observed. Third, laryngeal component, decreased intensity, pitch, loudness, variability affected, speed to initiate phonation is reduced, intensity peak across syllables is affected, increased fundamental frequency, increased shimmer, poor pitch control for visual motor tracking. And moving to the velopharyngeal mechanism, increased nasal airflow during non-nasal tachy production, reduced velocity and decreased vela movement during speech, abnormal spread of nasalization across syllables is observed. So while performing OPME, the lips is deviated into left side. Puckering, spreading is affected. Teeth looks normal, but chewing is affected. Tongue having tremors and fasciculation, but restricted protrusion and elevation. Jaw looks asymmetrical, but reduced range of motion. Moving to the swallowing and cognitive skills, while assessing the swallowing difficulty, they have a swallowing problem since 4 months post-hemorrhage. And the food consistency intake is semi-solid. Lip seal is inadequate, which is deviated to the left side. Laryngeal elevation present, aspiration present for both liquid and solid, and immediately and delayed after the intake. And mode of communication, while assessing the cognitive skills, the mode of communication is verbal, the comprehension, the auditory comprehension is adequate, verbal fluency is affected, naming looks normal, and writing is affected due to the right hemiparesis. So the detailed case history revealed that the patient is having restricted speech and swallowing skills with intact language and cognition. So after the administration of standardized test material, VAP, FDA, SAFE, we came into conclusion that the patient is having hypokinetic dysarthria with oropharyngeal dysphagia. So we can conclude that hypokinetic dysarthria reflects the effect on speech of aberration in the maintenance of proper background tone and supporting neuromuscular activity on which the quick, discrete phasic movements of speech are superimposed. The disorder helped to illustrate the role of the basal ganglia control circuit in providing an adequate neuromuscular environment for voluntary motor activity. Thank the jury team of AOCNR for providing me an opportunity to present the above case study, and my sincere gratitude to our Deputy Director, Professor N.D. Rajan sir, and my guide, Mr. Rakesh Sivi, Assistant Professor, ABMC Puducherry. Thank you.